Hello friends, today we'll see how to create a load balancer and assign a few of the EC2 instances into that. So first of all, we'll see and we'll create the EC2 instance. I'm selecting three-tier options. So we launch two instances directly with the same configuration, and let's forget about this configuration. Let's keep it as it is by default. And in here, in this text box, I will put a few commands which will install web server, and will create the index page with the hello world dash current IP address. So it will be useful in future to understand which server the load balancer is referring and transferring our request into that. Now let's go to the next step to add the storage. Let's keep it as it is. In here, we'll set the security group. And adding the SSH access. So in case if we want to connect these instances using SSH, then we can access this instance. Review and launch. Let's keep this, and as of now, we'll not require to access this because we can directly connect this to the cloud launch instance. I'm pausing recording until it launch perfectly. Okay, so both the servers are ready. Let's see if we can see our web page. So I'll use a public IP. Okay, seems like it's not able to connect. Let's see the security groups, because in our inbound rules, we have not allowed them to access through HTTP. So first of all, let's update the inbound rules. We'll add another rules with the HTTP to access through the browser. Okay, fine. We can see on the page. Let's check the same for the another instance as well. Okay, well, it is also working. Now, next step is to create the target groups. So this target group will be linked to the application load balancer. And here, there are a lot of options. So first of all, we want to, add the instances of the AWS itself. And if you want to include the instance of another hybrid data center, then you can use other options as well. So let's select this one and just we'll select default route. And in here, we'll need to give the HTML page which we want to check, because this property used to validate the health check of a particular page. So before application load balancer transfer the traffic, it check that if the page is healthy or not, and if it is healthy, then only it will transfer the traffic to this particular instance. Okay, let's go to the next. Okay, Here we need to select all the instances which we want to include in the target group. So I'll select both the instance with the port number, and then just create the target group. Okay, it is ready. Now let's go to the load balancer. Okay, here there are a lot of options with us, and you can just ignore other two options. And usually we are using the application load balancer, which gives better options to select the traffic based on the conditions. So let's create the application load balancer. Okay, these are the default options, and let's keep it as it is and don't change it. And here it allows us to select the subnets and regions in which we want to launch the load balancer. And this is the default security provider. So we just need to keep it as it is unless we want to change any other settings. This is the port number, and whenever we'll launch this application load balancer URL, then that URL will link to this particular property. And here we need to provide the target group in which we want to target our traffic to the instances. And let's keep all the settings as it is, as simple. I'm just creating the load balancer. I'm just pausing the video until it is ready. Okay, so load balancer is active now. And let's grab the DNS name of this load balancer. So we can assume that this is our website URL. Let's assume that it is our web URL. Let's hit the URL. It will not work because still we need to provide the access of this URL to the EC2 instance. So first of all, let's check the security group. Let me copy this and go to the instances. So both the instances have the same security group. So in security group, we need to ask the security group to give the permission to the load balancer to access these instances. So let's edit the security group, edit the inbound rules, and I'm adding here the HTTP rules so that it allows the traffic from the load balancer. Let's see it. Okay, it seems like it is ready. Let's check. Okay, now you can see that it is targeting to the different EC2 instances whenever they are clicking on it, and it is using the route robbing algorithm for that. So yes, that is all about the load balancer, and we'll create other videos for the other AWS cloud services. Thank you.